Hi children, in this question we are going to find x plus y plus z plus w. X, y, z and w. In previous question we had the same kind of drawing, but the polygon there is a triangle. And what polygon do we have now? 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is a quadrilateral. Okay, now we are going to name this angle as R. There we named it as A. Here we are going to name it as R. You can have any letter for that. So angle R is equal to R plus, if I add all these now, 1R, 120, 80 and 60. If I add the sum of all the angles in a quadrilateral is equal to what? 360. Sum of angles in a pentagon. If I have 5 sides, it is 540. If I have hexagon, add one more 80 along with 540. What will you get? 540, 640, 720. Is it clear? So it will keep on increasing. The sum of angles inside a polygon will keep on increasing if the number of sides increases. Okay, hope you understood this first line. From this we are going to find R. 120 plus 80 plus 60 is equal to 260. If I transpose this 260 to right hand side, I get angle R to be 100 degree. So what is the measure of R? It is 100 degree. Now using the concept of linear pair. What is mean by linear pair angles? The sum of angles in a straight line is 180 degree. Straight angle is 180 degree. With that concept, I have found X is equal to 180 minus 120. Just subtracting from 180, subtract 120 from 180, subtract 80 from 180, subtract 60 from 180. See, I have done all the things. The reason is linear pair. Those two angles are called as linear pair angles. If I add those two angles, I get 180 degree and it all makes a straight line, straight angle. So they are called as linear pair angles. So if I have found out X, Y, Z and W, I have to add all these four angles. What will be the answer? Yes, it is 360 degree. So sum of exterior angles, now these are all exterior angles, is 360 degree. Is it clear? Now we are going to talk about exterior angle. In triangle, we have two sets of exterior angles. Do they look the same? See here at this vertex, I have a line extended downwards, whereas here at the same vertex the line is extended towards left hand side. So the angle here in blue and the angle in pink are not the same angles. They are two different angles, isn't it? So I can say that these angles are taken in anti-clockwise direction. See here, it is extended this way and this way, whereas here in set 2, reverse way. In this point, I am not extending this line. Instead, I am extending this line segment here. Are you able to see that extension? So, these are all clockwise extensions. So, we have two sets of exterior angles. So, totally how many exterior angles are there for a triangle? Yes, we have six exterior angles for a triangle. See here. I have joined these two extensions. In this point, I can extend in both the ways. Isn't it? Here and this side also. Similarly, at this vertex, I can extend this side also. Now see here, this diagram and this diagram will look the same. So how many exterior angles do I have for a triangle? Six exterior angles are there for a triangle. Now can you say how many exterior angles there for a quadrilateral? Yes, we are going to have 8 exterior angles for a quadrilateral. Now, what is the property of this exterior angles? Just now we did one sum, no? X plus Y plus Z plus W. What angle did you get? Yes, it is 360. Even if it is a pentagon, even if it is a hexagon, nanogon, even if it has 20 sides, whatever may be the number of sides, if I add all the exterior angles taken in the same order, either clockwise or anti-clockwise. Here they have taken in this anti-clockwise. clockwise direction. Isn't it? Clock used to rotate this direction. So it is taken in anti-clockwise direction. All should be in one direction. Don't say if I mark the angle 3 here and not this one. Then will you say that sum of all the angles, all these angles are equal to 360 degree? No, we cannot say it. All should follow the same pattern. All the exterior angles should go in the same direction. Only then this property will hold true. Okay, what will be that angle? Yes, it will be equal to 360 degree. See here, the sum of the measure of the external, not interior. For interior, it keeps on differing. For triangle 180, for quadrilateral 360, for pentagon it is 540, for hexagon it is 720. It keeps on increasing. Interior angles, sum of interior angles. But now here I am talking about exterior angles of a polygon will always be equal to 360, whatever may be the polygon. Triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon, hexagon, nanogon, whatever may be it is, the sum of all the angles, exterior angle is equal to 360 degree taken in the same order. Don't forget that point. Is it clear, children? Shall we move to problems based on this? Okay, here is the thing. Take a regular hexagon. They have said it is a regular hexagon. Regular in the sense, it is equiangular and equilateral. All the sides are equal. What is the first question? What is the sum of the measure of its exterior? Exterior angles. How many exterior angles do this hexagon have? Yes, it will have 6 exterior angles taken along the same direction. What will be its sum? Yes, it will be equal to 360 degree. I don't need to see the problem. Whether it is regular or irregular polygon, sum of exterior angles taken in the same order, okay, is always 360 degree. Now coming over to the next question. This x is equal to y is equal to z is equal to PQR. All these exterior angles, will they be equal? Yes, surely it will be equal because it is a regular hexagon. All sides are equal, all angles are equal. If A, everywhere A. So surely it will be 180 minus A here. Here also Q will also be 180 minus A. R will also be 180 minus A. X will also be 180 minus A. Everywhere it will be the same. So you can say, yes, it is equal because it's a regular hexagon and P is equal to 180 minus A. Whatever I said, no, all these things you have to write. Q is equal to 180 minus A and everything. And what is the measure of each exterior angle? Come on. Now you should say me. What will be the exterior angle here? I said all the angles are equal. How many angles do I have in exterior? 6 angles I have. Totally how much? 360. So 360 divided by 360. I am not writing clearly. 360 by 6. So what will the measure of one angle? It will be equal to 60 degree. Isn't it? 60 degree. Exterior angle. This P is equal to 60 degree. This is 60. Q is also 60. R is also 60. Everywhere it is 60. So what about interior angles? 180 minus 60. What is 180 minus 60? 120. So all the angles here is going to be 120. If I add all these 126 times, what will I get? 6 2s are 12, carry 1, 720. So I said no, sum of interior angles in a hexagon is 720. Do I get it or not? So our answer is right. Now you have to do the same for octagon, regular octagon and regular 20-gon. This is a today's homework. And you have to post this work in group that you have done it in your classwork note. It should be done in your classwork note. With the diagram, if possible, for regular 20-gon, you will not be able to do it. So it's enough to do the calculation part alone. Is it clear, my dear children? It's compulsory and I will be expecting the work from everyone. So the next question is, yes, here we have a polygon. How many sides does it have? 5 sides. So it is a pentagon and I have to find x. Without doing any steps here, I'm going to directly find the answer. Okay, I have to find x, isn't it? Here it is 90. Will you all agree? Yes, with the symbol I should say. Here also it is 90. Here it is 180 minus 60. 180 minus 60 is 120. Okay, out of 5 angles, I have found 4. So here also I can find 180 minus 70, 110. How many angles I have found so far? 1, 2, 3, 4. This one if I find, I can find this x. What is the sum of angles in a pentagon? For quadrilateral, it is 360. For pentagon, what is the formula? N minus 2 into 180. Here sides is 5. 5 minus 2 is 3. Or you can have it in mind, the sum of angle is 540. Okay. Recall, my dear children. And this is a new concept. You may struggle or I may write the formula once again. N minus 2 into 180. This is the formula to find the angle interior, sum of interior angles. What I am finding? Sum of interior angles. If I add all these angles, what should I get? It is got by the formula n minus 2 by 180 degree. Here n minus 2 is, n is how many sides? 5 sides. 5 minus 2 is 3 times. So 3 into 180 is 540. So if I add all these 4 angles and subtract from 540, that will be this answer. Then this has to be subtracted from 180 to get the value x. Shall we see the steps now? See here. Angle y is equal to 90 degree. Here this they have considered as 90. Y. This is y. Then z is equal to 90 degree. This is z. Then x plus y plus 60 plus 70. 60 plus 70. They are saying this as y. Exterior angles. Going with the concept of exterior angles. Even then it is right, children. In both the ways you can do. Okay. X, y, z, this 70, all these exterior angles, sum of exterior angles is equal to 360 degree, and this is very simple compared to the one that I dealt earlier using the concept of interior angles. In both the ways you can do, but going for the simplest way which is stated here. Okay, so if I add these three things, these four things, I get 310 and it gets transposed and I get x is equal to 50 degree. Is it clear, my dear children? So the next question here is, find the measure of each exterior angle of a regular polygon of 9 sides. So we know that sum of the exterior angle is 360 degree. So it has to be divided by 9. That's all. 360 divided by 9 is what? 40 degree. So 9 sides they have given. So I am dividing it by 9. If it is 5 sides, in previous problem we divided by 5. Okay. So the next question is, here in this question, my dear children, we have to find the number of sides does a regular polygon have if each of its interior angle is 165 degree. Here they have given interior angle. If it is exterior, it is equal to 360 degree. Sum of all the exterior angles is 360. But now here I cannot say it as 360 because I don't know how many sides it has. So depending on it, we have n minus 2 into 180 as the total angle. What is the measure of total angle? N minus 2 into 180 degree. So how many sides do I have? N sides. Okay, so I divided by n to find the measure of one angle. What is the measure of one angle? N minus 2 into 180 divided by n. If you forget this, we will not be able to simplify this question at all. If they ask you for how many sides, you have to go by this way only. If it is interior angle, if it is exterior, divided by 360. 360 divided by 165 will give you that side. Okay, 360 divided by this 165, if this is the exterior angle. If it is interior, you have to remember this. Okay, so now transpose all the things, cross multiply 165 into n. Then you will bring